Hello dear viewer. Sometimes in Factorio we want to get rid of items. Even before Space Age, players designed wood burners for automatic wood disposal. The desire to void items has become a core part of Space Age, where we have to get rid of excess asteroids in space. Stone from the Vulcanus foundries and Fulgora is all about recycling, losing 75% of the materials in the process. But using the recycler and throwing items into space or lava only voids items. What if we want to get rid of fluids as well? The production of ammonia and ice on Aquilo is probably the best example that needs fluid voiding. While ice can be thrown into recyclers, there's no obvious solution for ammonia. If your Aquilo base has a low ammonia but high ice demand, you have a problem. So, how to void fluids? Build a machine that has a recipe requiring the fluid you want to get rid of and change recipes. The more fluid is required per craft, the better. You'll see why in a minute. Connect the machine to the fluid system. The game will fill the buffer with twice the crafting amount. Change the recipe to some other product, or no recipe at all. The fluid that was previously in the machine will be pushed back into the fluid system. To prevent this, we build a pump directly inserting into the machine. The pump forces the game to void the fluid because there is no backflow possible. In this example, I used the ice platform recipe to get rid of 800 ammonia each time I switch recipes. To automate the process, we utilize circuit logic. Let's first use the new selector combinator and a constant combinator to set this up, because it's the easiest solution. In the constant combinator, set two recipes. In this case, ice platform and any other recipe, like red circuits. Connect it to the selector combinator and set it to random input. The combinator will now randomly output one of the input signals. Next, connect the selector combinator to the assembling machine and set the set recipe option. Voila, the assembler is switching back and forth and the amount of fluid is decreasing. But can we increase the amount of fluid voiding? Can we improve this method? Let's set up two sets of four tanks containing 100,000 fluid. On the left side we built our previous setup, but on the right we set the update interval to 20 ticks. Reading the storage tank contents reveals that the method with an update interval of 0 was already the best option. Increasing the interval results in less fluid voided per time frame. But take a look at this experiment. This time I build a solution using a circuit logic clock on the right side. It's way faster compared to the selector combinator when using the right interval. Here's how to configure it. The clock counts to 40 using the ice platform signal. When reaching 40, the signal is reset to 0 for one tick, which is a moment the fluid gets voided. 40 seems to be the perfect setting for this method, providing the best results. If you want me to explain how the clock works, watch my thruster throttling video, where I explain it in detail. But what if we set up voiding, but we actually have an ammonia bottleneck? In this case, a permanent fluid voiding would be detrimental to our production. Don't worry, just connect the pipe to a storage tank to read the amount of fluid available and only enable the pump when the storage tank is about to be full. The condition ammonia is greater than 20,000 will do the trick. As I said earlier, the amount of fluid per craft is important. This is a comparison between ammonia voiding with the ice platform recipe versus the lithium recipe. Voiding 2 times 400 fluid is obviously way faster than 2 times 100. So, whatever fluid you want to get rid of, choose a recipe with a high amount of fluid needed per craft. For my Vulcanus base in my current 1000 Science Coast run on Twitch, I had to get rid of molten copper to make sure enough stone is being produced by the foundries. Only two recipes make sense here. Crafting low density structures requiring 250 molten copper, or the metallurgic science pack with 200 per craft. Choosing casting copper or copper cable is a bad idea. Not only because the amount voided per craft is low, but since these recipes don't require other materials, you will end up actually crafting copper plates or cables. This prevents the circuit logic from automatically changing the recipe. Thanks for watching. Hit the subscribe button if you're not subscribed already. And have fun setting this up to get rid of excess fluids in your base. Okay, bye.